time it is. Marvin Devine.
This is where it all began. This is where when I was filming earlier, this was what was called our palace. And this is, like I said, this is where it all began for me. And this is where it all began for, which you'll meet, which she's been on the channel before, my sis Dez. She is prepping for a show, and that's her friend Faith that you guys saw quickly. This is my first time meeting her, but they are prepping for a bikini show in about a month. They compete in Vegas, and I'm going to try to capture some of that today. We're going to be going through some bikini practice, her posing. We're going to take a look and see how their posing is and things of that sort. I am not an official coach. However, I have coached people before for those that are new to this channel. And it should be fun. We'll talk to her a little bit about just some of the changes that she's made, because she hasn't competed in a couple years. Some of the changes that she's made from her previous preps. She is amazing. She is wonderful. And she's one of the hardest working people that I know. And very committed, very dedicated to the cause. And she knows what she wants. And she looks amazing. Especially if you compare it to a couple years ago when she was competing. She has completely changed the way that she has done this prep, and it is really, really showing the improvements here and there, and she looked amazing before. So you know, that's what it's all about, is just learning your body and then making adjustments to a plan and sticking to it, being consistent, and not quitting when things maybe don't go as well or don't go according to plan. So I'll bring you along, and we'll see how this thing goes. So welcome to the palace, fam.
I get lost inside my thoughts, and when I start to think, oh, the Tahoe closest starts to end up on the brink. I tried so hard, but all these scars, they cut so deep. So fast from heaven, it's like someone clipped my wings. Now I'm falling, and I can't see the ground. Can we stop this gravity? It keeps bringing me down. I can't breathe, and I don't wanna die. Can we stop this gravity?
My sister is a beast. As you guys can see, we were just talking about, she's about a month out from the show, as I mentioned earlier, and we were talking about the, as far as when you're in preparation, should you be worried if you're maybe peaked, if you feel like you peaked too soon? Like, she's pretty shredded. You guys just saw the video and you saw her back, and she's pretty shredded already and about a month out. So my advice to her was to embrace that, because the last thing you want to do is be stressed as you get closer to the show because you're worried about if you're going to peak. Now, can you peak too soon? Yes. I mean, you definitely can. However, if you get to a point where you're like, okay, I'm really on point. I could get on stage. Like right now, she probably could get on stage today, a month prior to the show. So it's a lot easier, and nothing's easy, but it's easier to maintain where you're at and still make small improvements as opposed to struggling to get to where you want to get to prior to the show. So just some tips, advice, I guess. Not the expert, but those are things that I've learned along the way, and hopefully that'll help you if you are interested in competition or even if you're setting a goal, you know, because sometimes you may reach your goal sooner than the planned goal date, but that doesn't mean that you quit and you stop there. Set a new one and then restart and get to another goal, you know what I mean? So, but she looks amazing, and you guys get a chance to see more of her. She's being slick right now. I don't know what she did. I think she might have Snapchatted me, but we'll capture more of sister. Say hi, sister. All right, sister, they're going to want to know, what is the biggest change that you've done in this prep compared to, because I think I told them 2 years the last time you competed, but it's been what, 2015?
Yeah.
When we competed in Phoenix?
Yeah.
So since 2015, she has not been on stage. So what is something different that you did this time compared to last?
So I started back into getting fit and eating healthy with intermittent fasting and actually eating mostly keto.
Okay.
So
it was more nutrition?
Nutrition.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So changed up the nutrition plan.
Yeah.
And was there any changes with your workout? But you also had a coach back then.
So I've had many coaches.
Yeah. She should be a coach.
But yeah, I've had many coaches, and I just took a little bit of what worked best from each coach and implemented it in what I started doing.
Okay.
Yeah.
I like. And what is your worst, your work rest cycle?
This is me in prep mode for getting my backpack in the gym, so I decided to come get it.
Hey, that's the life of a competitor right there, is forgetfulness, laziness. But you fight through the laziness, though. The forgetfulness, you recover
can't
from
help that.
But you're doing how much cardio? Well, it's probably, has it increased or has it decreased since you've gotten closer?
Since I've gotten closer, I've decreased it a little bit. Just because I was doing cardio probably 6 days a week.
Okay.
45 minutes to an hour on the stairs.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, so.
So you were like in super beast mode.
So, I've decreased it, yeah.
Now, if you were to give advice to anyone, would you say that would be because I mean, obviously you can't tailor it towards someone if you don't know their body or how well their body responds. But if you were to give advice on like someone that's new, that's starting, would you tell them to start off with a lot of cardio or to ease their way into it? And see how their body maybe responds?
Yeah, I mean, I would ease into it, you know, like, it just, like, it's like you said, it depends on how your body responds, and you have to keep up with it. That's the thing. It's like, to be able to get a good understanding of what your body is going to do and how it's going to react to the cardio, you have to keep up with it. You can't just say, oh, I've been doing cardio for a couple weeks and nothing's happening. Like, you have to keep doing it.
So you would say consistency is probably
consistency
number one.
Is the key.
Nice.
Yeah.
Now, do you feel like in previous preps, do you feel like your consistency wasn't as on point? Or do you feel like, because from an outsider's perspective, for me, you know, knowing you and seeing you go through prep in the past, like I always thought you were consistent. I mean, you're one of the people I look up to.
My consistency is pretty much the same.
I'm sitting with you. Hi, sitting with you.
My consistency has pretty much been the same. It's hard to remember exactly what I was doing back then in 2015.
Yeah.
But
it's a long time ago.
I do know that for whatever reason, I felt like this prep was a lot less stressful. I've just been...
Maybe because you already knew, you had an expectation already, like you know what to prepare for, like...
Mm-hmm, yeah.
What made you decide to step back on stage? Because, you know, that's a long time to be out of the game, and it's not easy to get back on track. I mean, I know just having a small off season for me and getting back, like right now, I'm trying to get my mind, like before I worry about training, it's my mind I got to get right.
That's true. And so the thing that got me thinking back into wanting to compete, which I was actually not thinking about ever competing again, and thought that I did it, it was a goal that I achieved, and I can say that I've done it, and I didn't really care to do it ever again.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
So I'm gonna get emotional.
She's an emotional person, and there's nothing wrong with that at all. That's just passion, you know?
But so my really, really, really close friend, Faith, if you're watching this, you already know.
Hi, Faith. You saw her in the beginning. That's Faith, right?
The red pants?
Yeah.
The red pants.
So she has, yeah. Well, because I like red, so that's why. So, yes, you guys saw her in the beginning. I filmed her briefly.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
That was Faith.
Okay.
So, Faith is the reason, long story short, is the reason why I thought about and actually decided to compete again. And so.
Nice.
Yeah.
But it's Faith's very first. She's never done it before.
She's never competed, no. And she... we were talking about it a lot when we first met in Sicily, and so when I was telling her all about it and competing, and it just kind of like inspired her, I guess, and she started looking more into it, and then she decided she wanted to do it, and it's, yeah.
Kind of lit your fire a little bit?
It did.
Nice.
It was nice. The kindling to my fire.
Nothing but kerosene.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Mm-hmm. Hey, sometimes you need someone else to remind you. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I think, you know, on social media, it's out there, you know, and it's never going away. If anything, there's more competitors out there now than it was when we started.
Yeah.
And I feel like we started late. Like, I mean, you started, what, 14 or 13 in Okinawa?
Actually, like, into fitness and wanting to compete? Yeah, it was like 13, 12 okay. or 13.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's grown immensely since then.
Yeah.
And
that's the thing, is like, I can't imagine if I were to have been in the same mindset as I am now back then.
Yeah.
That's when all of the really, really, like, professional, like, amazing, inspirational competitors who are today, that's when they started, like,
yeah.
back then. And so it kind of is like, I wonder where I could be now, because I do enjoy it now and I love it. But then again,
yeah, you know, life happens.
Yeah,
and you can't. There's no prevention for that. I mean, competing is not for everyone, so we don't want you to think that we're putting any pressure on anyone to compete. I mean, competing is probably not the healthiest route to go, and I've said that on this channel numerous times. But if you can find a niche, and it's something that you want to go after, you have to go in both feet. Like, there's no half step in your way into a competition, you know, and just, I mean, you look at the time period that Dez took off, you know, she had to refine it. You got to refine your why. You got to refine that purpose, that passion, to be able to stick to it, because
it's easy to quit.
Oh, it's so, every day there's a moment where I'm like, I could just quit. I don't need to do that, or I don't have to do that, or just, there's every day there's a moment in time where you're like, do I really want to?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's hard to find that drive every single day sometimes, especially when your carbs are low and you just don't have much energy. And yeah, I think you have to remind yourself, like, why am I doing this? And how bad do you want it, you know?
Yeah.
I think that's the difference too between lifestyle and competing.
Mm-hmm.
Because as lifestyle, you can kind of say, oh, I can take today off. You know, it's not going to hurt me. I, you know, my goal is still there. I can still get it. But when you're competing, you have a deadline.
Yeah.
And that deadline ain't changing. So you have to stick with it.
Especially when you've already made reservations, yeah, and you've paid, and you've, you know, invested in that one day.
Right.
Coach, like, that's one of the reasons why this time I didn't get a coach, because I've worked with so many that I kind of know how my body reacts and responds. And so, like, that was one thing that I kind of enjoyed, is that I was paying somebody to prep me. Yeah. Which is motivation, because I'm paying them. I don't want to waste money.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And so, like, this time I was like, well, I've learned so much, and I feel like I could do it my own, you know?
Yeah.
And so that's another challenge. It's the thing where it's like, I'm not paying somebody. I don't have to do this. I can skip it or do, you know, that's right. You have to keep yourself going.
Right. Accountability, mm-hmm. You know, at its finest. Well, she's going to do some posing. Thank you, sis.
Of course.
It's been a long time since she's been on the channel, and she's going to do a little bit of posing. I'm going to film a little bit. Not a lot, because it's more just, I just want to watch and see. And then we will do this again, where we actually can take our time and get this thing down. She's going to be ready. I mean, she's already there. I'll definitely put her Instagram info on here so you guys can see it. If you want to reach out to her and talk to her or anything, I mean, if it's life, because she's been through a lot. She is an Air Force vet, active duty, and thank you for your service. We served together.
Yes.
At two different bases, even actually, though we didn't know each other at one, but you know, it is what it is. But yeah, this is my sis, and I'm proud of her. I love her to death, and she's been with me from the beginning.
Been
so.
Through a lot.
Right? So I was happy to hear that she was going to compete again, but I'm glad that she's here doing it, you know, as opposed to not being here, so I could actually be
a part of it, yeah.
You know, this ride. And it pushes me too, you know what I mean? Because I know that I'm kind of off season, improvement season, but I'm getting back, and this is motivating me to, like, oh yeah, if sis is getting it, I got to get it. But we'll talk to you soon. Take an eye out on this posing and take some notes. Because, yeah, professional here. All right. Thanks, sis. Peace. Well, my YouTube family, as you can see, I'm obviously working, but I apologize because I did cut that video a little bit short. This year for 2020, I am trying to be a lot more efficient with the videos, but I hope that you guys got something out of this. The one thing that I do want to leave you with as I close this video out is, you don't have to be a competitor to be great. When it comes to fitness, I don't want anyone to think that just because you're a competitor that you're so much more above the average person. You know, it's about lifestyle. And if you put competition in there, that's just a bonus on top of lifestyle. But what's most important is the lifestyle piece. And some of the things that were discussed between me and Dez, we're talking about consistency for any goal, regardless if it's fitness or lifestyle or if it's school or business or whatever the case may be, consistency is going to be a key regardless. Hard work is going to be a key regardless. Dedication, commitment, a focus. It starts with your vision. And from there, it's a matter of going for it and not giving up on the vision. Don't quit on your vision. You're going to get adversity. It's an up and down road. That's life. And, you know, there's things that you cannot prevent, and you can't stop those things, and you can't let it stop you from accomplishing what you want. So this was just the beginning. And like I said, she's a month out. Faith is a month out. But I wanted to capture that because it's something different. And I wanted you to get a different perspective outside of my own when it comes to competing and changes that you can make. And just because maybe it's been 4 years since you've been on stage, or even if you were, say you had did a transformation and then you fell off the horse, you know, you can get back on. Even if it's 4 years later, get back on the horse. You know the pathway. You just got to get back on the path and walk it, you know? So to close this out, first I want to say thank you. Thank you to Faith. Thank you to Dez. Thank you to Fitty. I appreciate them. Even though I didn't capture them much, hopefully the next time when we meet up and they are practicing, hopefully the next time I can get more and we can capture their journey. But thank you guys. If you have any questions, I put their Instagram names on the screen for you. And like I said, I just hope that at least one person is affected by this and maybe learn something, especially from the discussion piece and everything. So until the next time, I hope everyone had a great weekend, and we will talk soon. So I appreciate all the support, and until the next video. All right, fam. Peace.